Okay, I'm having a really weird moment here. Like, I remember as a kid growing up, and you watch, television, and you read newspapers, and you look at magazines, and, everyone has these, aspiring ideas of the future. And you always keep them in the back of the head, because you want to see the future. Well, it's September 1st, 2023, when I make this video. It is the future. And I just had that moment where I realized I really am in the future. So here I am. I am at my computer. And I am opened into a browser for the World Wide Web. Because really what this is a bunch of pages, hypertext pages, all linked together over a giant network that I have sudden access to. And I want to read an issue of Popular Science. Not this month's issue, but an issue from 30 years ago. And there's a lot of these hypertext pages that are available. So, of course, there's a search engine that has access to all of this information, one of which is if I were to search for I want to find issues of Popular Science, you might find Google Books. Google Books has an entire section that is dedicated specifically to Popular Science, and they have it arranged by decade. If I want to look at the 1930s, not a problem. 1960s, not a problem. 1990s, same idea. So if I want to, I can just scroll until I find September 1993. I can click on that. Now, here's the issue. It's 116 pages, volume 243, issue number 3, the ISSN number, the copyright, and just kind of a small footnote just to tell me what I'm going to go into on this one here. And then at that point there, I can just click this, and it'll let me straight in to the actual digital copy of this magazine, and I can scroll through it. Well, I'm scrolling through this here, and I get to something that I'm kind of interested in. What's that? It's the future. And it arrives every week on the TV series that takes you to the leading edge of technology and beyond. Beyond 2000, Wednesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern and Pacific on the Discovery Channel. This is really cool, but this is also something I'll never be able to watch. Like, I remember shows when the Discovery Channel didn't suck. And even this here, like 1993, I was way too young to remember this. Well, okay, Beyond 2000 sounds interesting. I wonder if there's anything else on the web that talks about Beyond 2000, because I want to get more information on this one topic. Well, again, this is where a search engine comes in handy, and it's just got this ability to let me access and look around through my criteria of the TV series Beyond 2000, and it'll bring back anything that it can find that is most relevant to that topic. In this case here, there was some 312 million results that it was able to pull up for me in 0.42 seconds. Australian television series, we have a cast here. Jamie Heineman and Adam Savage are part of this series. Interesting. And it ran from 1985 to 1999. There's other criteria that follows along with it here. For example, there's this other website, just a whole other set of hypertext pages called Wikipedia. And Wikipedia, it's like an encyclopedia, but it's a digital version that you can modify yourself. And yes, this sounds like obvious, like, yeah, well, obviously, duh, it's Wikipedia. Yeah, this, think about this here, though. Think about this from the perspective of the early 90s, like where we're going here so far. And so, okay, so I know I can look at the IMDb if I want, or I can look at the Wikipedia. And the Wikipedia comes up, and this is information that is relevant to Beyond 2000. Debuted in ABC in 1981 as a half-hour show. Like, it changed to Beyond Tomorrow in 2005. I have some photographs that are available to give me an idea of the media, just to show me what the show was like. But at the same time, let's say, okay, so I've seen an advertisement. I have a general idea now what the show is like. I really wish that I could see what this show looked like when it was still airing on television, beyond 2000 at 475 episodes. Well, I can just simply go back to our search engine and say, well, let's refine the criteria of what I want to look at to just videos. And it brings up a bunch of episodes of Beyond 2000, which are available on another hypertext link website, which simply just hosts videos, you know, YouTube. And I can click on that. Let's say this first one here, The Future of Computers. And it'll bring it up. And it is 58 minutes, 31 seconds. It's 640 by 480, 30 frames a second. And now it's like I can grab popcorn and I can sit down. And I've gone from reading a digital magazine to looking up a topic that I found in that magazine instantaneously on my computer. And from that topic, I was able to not only find like a full text article, I was then also able to then on demand look up an episode of this show from 1992, and now I can watch it in its entirety. The future is now. The future is absolutely now.